There is many different corkscrew openers on the market here. I have three of the most common. The rabbit here, this is for old wine, and then the classic one used by most sommeliers. When you open a bottle of wine, often the sommelier tells you to cut it here or underneath. Some insist underneath. I mean, what's important is that the wine itself, when it's poured, does not touch the metal. The metal or plastic now, most of the time. So on this one here, you would want to make sure that you go in the center of the cork, hold it a little bit, and start pouring, opening it with the first layer here, this way, and then lift it up, go to the second level, and lift it up again. So it's an easy way of opening it. If you have an old bottle of wine, what I like to do is just to cut the top this way, and then using that two-pronged thing, well, it's an old bottle of wine because often the cork will have a tendency to crumble, so you use this. One is longer than the other, so you put one first, then the other one, and you kind of jigsaw or move it this way back and forth to get it. And here, I probably have to put it between my leg to twist it like that and bring it back up. You have made no hole in the cork at that point, and if it's old and crumbly, that's how you save it. If I want to show that cork, the way that I cut it on top, I will cut that fourth level here, lift that up, put my cork in it, fold it, and I'll present my cork like that. If you want to open champagne, you first have to chill it. And a common mistake is done, people put ice in there, but cannot push it back in. You have to put water. Also, that you have water, very easy to go in, and that would cool up very fast. If you really want to go even faster, you put salt in it. And the salt make it much colder, and it will chill very fast. Now, when you're ready to open it, clean up your bottle of champagne from the bottom. Now you always have to watch out for the pressure in there. Find the little round thing of metal. Take this out. There is usually a little red. Oh, here it is, yes. And then you unscrew this, putting your thumb on top of it, just to make sure. And then press it and move the cage out. Okay, now the secret to open the bottle of champagne, grab the bottom part of it, your cork, don't tuck the cork, turn the bottom part of it, and theoretically it shouldn't make much of a noise, just a little bit of noise this way. When you pour champagne, you always pour twice. The first time the foam comes up. So if you have several glass, you serve them, and you pour a second time after. À votre santé.